Hi, this is Rich, and welcome to my blog. Hey, I want to talk to you about the importance of getting out of body, or learning how to get out of body, consciousness shift. It's not just about running around, having a good time, getting free of your body, like, oh, I'm free of my body, yay. There's a lot going on in the higher planes. There's a lot going on as a relationship between this realm and the other realms, this plane of existence and the other planes, third density, fourth density, fifth density, all this stuff. Once you start getting out of body and start exploring and learning, and you're literally going to universities and learning things, you're talking to people in spacecraft, you're talking to elven beings, other planes that are parallel worlds, alternate realities. Then there's the astral planes of Earth. There's all these different things you can be doing in the multiverse. It's absolutely amazing. But what happens is it wakes you up to the difference between what is going on as in life as a human being in comparison to what life could be as a non-human spiritual being. This is important these days because on planet Earth, those in control understand the multidimensionality of reality, and they do not want you or me waking up, learning how to get out of body, consciousness shift, flip into the other reality systems, awaken the third eye, see beyond the physical. They don't want any of that happening because they want us to be imprisoned into what we call prison planet Earth. It's once you drop dead here, you can go between lives, and some of us can just go free. This place is not a prison to us. But for the others of us, this place, you drop dead here, you go between lives, you get caught up in various between lives scenarios, implant stations, fake heaven worlds. You get caught up in these realms where you are talked into agreeing to come back to the physical world yet again. And the idea, if you're on the plane on the dark side, is to get these beings of light, these energy beings, we create energy to get us to keep coming back into physical bodies where they can control and manipulate, influence, and dominate us. If they can do that, they can win. We're like genies, and we're in the bottle. Our physical bodies is like a bottle. We are totally controlled, manipulated, and handled while we're in the bottle. If we get out of the bottle, we're free. And we have these incredible abilities to manifest anything we think of. That's the sort of thing that can happen when you get out of body and you start exploring the multiverse. Okay, there's some realms you're like, you've got all your superpowers, and there's some realms out there where you don't have your superpowers. It's very much like here, except there's no pain and there's no death, and there's the game of life is more enjoyable, like playing on an online game here. You get online and you play, and maybe you're shooting and killing people, but it's okay. You're not an evil person. You're playing. Okay. You get shot, you get killed in the game. It's okay. It didn't hurt. And you can respawn, but you have your memory when you respawn. When you pick up another body in your game world, you have a memory of the last time you played. You can play a different strategy. You can do it. It's fun. You can quit anytime you want. Well, this world, this physical universe, is very much like that, except for a lot of people, especially on Earth, we've come into the game and now we can't remember outside the game. And if we get partway out of the game, it's kind of like you're sitting at your keyboard playing an online game. It's all fun. You got your virtual reality guys, and you're really immersed in the game. And it's all great. And you die. You pop out. And now you're sitting here, damn, and you know, blank screen. And you go, oh, shoot. And you got your VR glasses on. You take them off. And you're at your desk. And about the time you start to go, physical reality, real, this is my real life, By the time that happens, somebody comes over and grabs you and puts a bag over your head and more chloroform over your head, and they knock you out and redrug you, put virtual reality glasses back on you, sit you down in the chair and immerse you into the game again, and you don't remember being outside the game. You just remember dying in the game and waking back up in the game. Why? Because somebody wants you plugged in and online all the time because somehow they got a fucking power cord up your ass or something, and they're draining you of your spiritual fucking power. while you're plugged in to this system. So they don't want us to be free. And they will do what they can to influence you, manipulate you, to get you to agree to come back into the physical world again. And it may not always be a benign agreement. Okay, I agree. It just like somebody could drive down the street and grab somebody off the street and throw them in a van and take off. You don't have to be agreed to be grabbed and thrown in a van or knocked over the fucking head and rendered unconscious. And then wake up in some third world country at the mercy of this human traffickers. You don't have to agree in that way to end up captured and enslaved. And that's what's happened to us here. A lot of us, most of us, here on planet Earth, prison planet, for real, this place is a place you don't break free from. But you can. You can learn how to get out of body. You can learn how to, I'd say astral travel, but if you're limited to the idea and the concept of traveling in the astral plane in an astral body, you can do that. You can lay down in your bed and shift consciousness, imagine your astral body or project your astral body outside of your physical body, or just rock back and forth, and you look at your body and tune in to the astral planes around Earth. But these are part of the trap. This is part of the system of enslavement. So you want to not just astral travel, because if you got out of your body and traveled astrally, like fly through the air, and you fly away, and you want to fly away from Earth, you're in the Earth's astral plane. So you got astral Earth. It doesn't matter if it's flat or globe or round. It doesn't matter the size or shape of it. You're on the astral turf, and you fly away. There is an astral shield. It's in the astral, or the astral is affected by it. It covers anyone trying to go through this energy grid around Earth, put in place to keep us from breaking free. So if you astrally travel, you may hit part of this grid and be stuck here, bounce back, freak out, come back, different kinds of scenarios, but the grid is there to hold us in, even if we're in our astral bodies. But the other way of getting out is more like jumping, quantum jumping, or consciousness shifting. You're basically teleporting from your physical experience. You're teleporting out of the physical reality system. You wink out and you wink back in, you go bing, and you manifest in a different plane, dimension, realm, in some galaxy far, far away, or in some belief system territory that is way beyond the trap that is the physical and the astral prison planet Earth trap and the energy grid around Earth. You're out of here and you're there. Different place. Not trapped. This is not a prison for you. It's not a prison planet for you. And you can just do this. Some people can do it, some can't. But right now, in this world, it's a good time to learn how to do these kind of spiritual activities. Why? Because the dark forces are doubling down on controlling humanity in all kinds of ways. And we have this window of opportunity to learn and share what we have learned and wake up and help awaken the other beings that are here to be awakened and want to wake up to a better experience of life in the multiverse. So we have this opportunity to do this. Now, one way, part of getting out of body has to do with what you've agreed to being in a body. Some of us, we agree that we're stuck, we can't get out. We agree that it's hard to get out of body. All these agreements we make, well, these cluster around soul contract agreements. It's like the soul contract agreement is the core, and these other agreements are built on that. And so these can keep us from being able to learn how to get out of body. So learning how to do soul contract revocation is a good thing, not for just getting out of body, but for all kinds of things, relationship issues, money issues, all kinds of things. But it's pretty important these days. I've been looking at this coronavirus thing, and the regular flus from years gone by, way worse. epidemic, you know, over 100 million people get the flu, big deal. Some people die of it because, you know, it turns into pneumonia or some other complications, really old people, really young people, who knows, right? But it's normal. This time, the deep state, the cabal, wanted to make a big deal out of the latest virus outbreak, flu thing. And that's what they're doing. They're just doubled down, man. It's just covered everywhere. And they've got the world in a panic. They're attempting to crash the economy with this. And it's nowhere near as bad as last year's or year before last. Look at the statistics for flu. How many people got the flu? How many people died of the flu last year? I could segue into talking about the coronavirus and how it came from a bioweapons lab in Wuhan, and how they did a six weeks before the outbreak, they were doing a simulation of what if there was an outbreak like this. Just the same way they had a simulation going the day of 9/11, they had a simulation attack on the World Trade Center on the same morning as the real attack. They did the same thing in London when they had a terrorist attack in one of the train stations. They were running a simulation of a terrorist attack in the train station, and they had the real terrorist attack. They do that kind of crazy shit. This is a good time to learn and wake up to all kinds of things that's going on in the physical world, the next dimension out, the next out, and all this. The astral planes, fourth density, fifth density, and the war in heaven. It's a war in physical heaven, or the heavens, the stars. It's a war in the galaxy, trade, commerce in the galaxy, human trafficking right now in our galaxy. All kinds of stuff's going on right now. And we need to wake up to what it is and who's doing it and why. So that we can, if you can't change your conditions a lot while you're here in the physical world, at least when the body drops dead, you can break free and escape prison planet Earth. So, yeah, I highly recommend learning how to get out of body. I highly recommend learning how to do soul contract revocation and learn what's going on in the world. Stop looking at mainstream media. It's the Mockingbird Press. It's the propaganda arm of the CIA, and the CIA is the strong arm muscle of the deep state. And the deep state is just another political arm of the shadow government. And the shadow government, there's shadow government in our government and all various governments all over the world, which are being puppeted by the super rich power elite. It's time to wake up. We got to. Yeah, it's time. It's a good time. Okay? All right. I'll talk to you later. All right.